Good morning, class 5. Happy Wednesday. We're halfway through the week, and today we're doing some work on relative clauses. Tomorrow and Friday are our story writing sessions, which I'm really excited about. And I can't wait to see your stories that you send in when you finish writing on Friday. It's been so long, actually, since I've had an extended piece of writing from everyone. So I can't wait to see all of the skills that we've been focusing on over lockdown in pieces of your work. And I'm sure they're all going to be fantastic. So really looking forward to spending this weekend looking through all of those, because you're all such wonderful story writers, and you've always got something creative to say. So just make sure for tomorrow that you put it all into planning, and then spend a really good hour on Friday writing a quality short story for me. Anyway, on with today, relative clauses. I've got a little PowerPoint for you today that I'm going to talk through. It's just a revision session, as we've done relative clauses before. So I'll probably be repeating lots of stuff you already know, but hopefully it's useful. And there's a little bit in there to help you with punctuation as well. So enjoy. Let's revise relative clauses. So we start by thinking, what is a relative clause? How can we write them? A relative clause gives more information about a noun or a pronoun, and they usually begin with a relative pronoun. That's why they're called relative clauses. Relative pronouns and relative adverbs are who, which, whom, whose, that, and where and when. The design covers the box. How could you tell me more about the design using one of the relative pronouns? You could say the design, which appeared overnight, covers the box. If you're not sure what box we're talking about, I'm talking about the green electricity box in the picture on the screen, which has been graffitied. Can you think of another one? The design, which is brightly coloured, covers the box. Or the design, which expresses gratitude, covers the box. And we all know that gratitude means thanks. Here's three more, using which, that and whose. So which had been rather dull looking, that no one had noticed before, whose exact purpose no one knew. Relative clauses can also relate to whole clauses. Anna hated the art. This is a clause. Anna hated the art, which annoyed Mackenzie. It was not the art that annoyed Mackenzie. It was that Anna hated it. The relative clause relates to the whole clause. Punctuating relative clauses. Now, this is important. When the order is main clause and relative clause, you don't use a comma. There were four hands that were shaped to spell love. The main clause is there were four hands. The relative clause and the subordinate clause that were shaped to spell love. A comma would create an unnecessary break in the sentence. The relative clause tells us the extra information about the main clause. When the relative clause splits the main clause, we use commas. So it goes main, relative clause, clause. The design, which includes a toilet roll, is striking and skillful. And you can see there that the relative clause is splitting that main clause. And the commas help to separate this. Placing a clause in the middle is called embedding.